Hi, my name is Kevin Riem. I'm the Vice President and General Manager at Crownline Boats, and we're here today to do a product walk-around video on our brand new E25. Now, when I say brand new, I mean it's brand new. It's a brand new deck design, brand new hull design. The running surface has been redesigned to deliver a performance fast-ab hull. It's got a brand new upholstery, an upgraded list of standard features, and it comes with several different dash options to make sure that we have something for everybody. Now, before we get started, let me hit a little bit on the specs. This boat is 25 feet, 3 inches in total LOA. It's an 8.6 beam boat, and it weighs in at 5,700 pounds. The dead rise in the back here at the transom is 19 degrees, and the angle of entry at the keel is 39. We find that that's our sweet spot to maximize performance, maximize throttle response, also minimize bow rise, and make sure that we deliver the best overall performance boat to the marketplace. So let's get started as we go through this exciting new boat, and we'll take it step by step to make sure you understand what's all available on this exciting new E25. Because so much of your boating pleasure happens really towards the back of the boat oftentimes, I want to take a few minutes to go through the layout and the design of this E25 in the transom area. First, we've designed in our social swim transom design, which incorporates splash-proof speakers to the back of the boat. We trademarked this name and this design when we brought it to the market first in 2002. As we move around the transom, we move over here to feature our standard freshwater washdown. This way, if you board the boat from the transom and you're full of sand or debris, you can easily hose off and have it exit the boat before you ever enter into the cockpit. The other thing I want to point out is this boat is actually detailed with a teak mat. It's got a teak cockpit mat, also the platform mats. It's got a non-slip, soft touch finish, and it's actually got a brush finish to actually aid in traction. So even if it's wet, has a little bit of frost if you're boating in the fall, this brushed finish really helps to avoid slips and falls. Moving over, we have a full-length ski tow rail with a ski tow eye, stainless steel, 1-inch diameter. And over here, we also have a fingertip LCD transom remote that controls the whole entertainment system. So when the speakers are designed off the back of the boat, you're allowed to control your whole entertainment center from this LCD transom remote. Another standard feature on this boat is our 3-bank battery charger. Again, if you've been on the water all day, maybe you've tied up with other boats or run your stereo all day, it's not only this 3-bank battery charger not only charges your charging battery, but your secondary battery. The other thing to point out is this boat comes standard with a dual battery switch. So when you plug this in at the end of your boating day, it'll automatically charge both batteries in the system. Last thing I want to point out is we have embossed pull-up cleats located in the rear section of this boat, so they're easily to tie off to docks or other boats. And lastly, I want to point out this huge oversized rope locker in the back. This way, if you have tow ropes or things that you use for water toys, you can easily store them in here. It's self-draining and closes back out to make sure that you have access and storage for everything you need when you're on the water. The cockpit design on the E25 is what we call a J-wrap, and it's really designed to have a circular area for plenty of seating. So 4, 5, 6 people can get together, have something to eat, have drinks, have a conversation area. It's also why it comes standard with the built-in table base right below me here. Because when you put the table base and the portable table in place, again, this becomes a dining area, a cocktail area, but for sure a conversation area. Now let me take it kind of part by part and show you some of the great features of each part of this cockpit design. It starts with the sunbed. Now, this sunbed is an electric sunbed, and it's a push button, finger touch release, and you can stop that sunbed at any position. You can do the rear 3/4 and look out the back of the boat. You can come all the way down and have it go into a full 6-foot sunbed without the use of filler cushions. But the point being, it's because it's electric, you can put it in any position you want and stop it to make sure it's just right for what you want to do during that particular time on the water. Also over here on the rear port side, we have a feature that we're really proud of, and that is what we call the hands-free hinges. We design these into our boats everywhere we possibly can because it allows you to open access to the storage and still have your hands free to load, unload items in and out of the boat. The other thing I'd like to point out is just how deep the storage is. Again, if you step down, you see that it comes up to my mid-thigh, and there's plenty of area, storage area here for canvas, water toys, anything else you might bring on board. We ship our standard bow and cockpit canvas to our dealers located inside the storage area when we do ship it. Now that rear cushion is a fixed position cushion, but again, the way this is designed is you got complete access all the way to that rear portion of that storage cavity. Over here, I call this seat the love seat. It's really kind of located behind the driver's seat. It's big enough for one. Sometimes you can get two people to sit there. What this design is all about is that this is a built-in oversized insulated cooler. Again, it's a hands-free, but it's a slightly different mechanism because it's hands-free based on the stainless steel shock. But when this boat is built, we spray in foam, closed cell foam, all around the design of this area to insulate it. That way you can fill it with ice, put drinks, put food, anything you want to bring on board for your day on the water, and it's self-draining back to the bilge. So as it melts down slowly over time, the water drains through the drain hole to the bilge and exits outside the boat. This is one of our most popular features because the storage capacity is about 84 quarts ballpark. So it's more than two times the oversized carry-on coolers in most other boats. Action. Next, let's talk about the performance bucket seats of the E25. These bucket seats come standard with built-in suspension seat bases and flip-up bolsters. Now that's both the driver and the passenger side. They also spin 360 and slide forward and back. That way, if you're sitting in the boat and pointing forward and you come to a rest, you can easily spin the seats around and become part of the conversation in the cockpit. Moving on to the dash, what we're displaying with this particular boat is what we call a black dash. The hand wrap double stitch brow is standard. Also, the upgraded premium black diamond steering wheel with the stainless center is also standard. But what this particular dealer chose to do was option up the dash so it was entirely a black vinyl dash. What I wanted to point out is that this is a standard configuration with two 5-inch oversized gauges. We also have a standard GPS landing on this dash assembly. Now, what we offer on this particular boat is a variety of options for people that want upgraded electronics. You have two choices. One, you can add the Raymarine A67. If you option that up, the Raymarine A67 touchscreen will be installed in this landing here. With that system, you also get the secondary transducer, so you have sonar, you get the gateway cable, so you have engine information and fuel flow, and you also get the Navionics Plus chip standard for mapping. The other option with our new E25 is you can upgrade all the way up to the 7-inch touchscreen, which is the standard dash on the E27. So those that want a bigger touchscreen display, so those that want more digital electronics and a bigger digital experience, you can have a second option to upgrade all the way to the 7-inch touchscreen dash in this particular model as well. So we think that we give a lot of options to our customers and allow you to personalize your boat in a manner that works best for you and your family. The last feature I'd like to point out is over here on the shifter panel and the ergonomically designed armrest for the driver so that he can rest his arm in positions when he's using his throttle. First thing I can point out is that we use only premium throttle and shift cables on all of our boats. They're guaranteed not to kink or bind up. It's a very expensive option that we do standard on all of our product. Again, the way we design in this armrest is so that when you're at the helm station, your arm is in the full right position, be able to maintain throttle control, and that way you're not worrying about your arm getting tired or coming off the throttle. It's designed in so that it's a brace for the driver at all times. One of the other nice features of the E25 is I like to point out the oversized floor storage. Now, first of all, please note the finished B-side lid. In 2018, we went to all of our center cockpit storage lids to be RTM, so you have a finished A and B-side. Second, we support all of our lids with only stainless steel shocks, and we also have drain holes set up, so if there's a water that is caught in the drain channel, it drains out of the boat and into the bilge to exit the boat. Now, again, it's hard to get reference and exactly what we're talking about and how big this space is, but if you see that I step down and we're basically up to the knees and how deep this storage area is, and it also goes forward to about the helm station area here. This is where you would accommodate things like wakeboards, surfboards, water skis, inflatable water toys, those kinds of things. Those are bigger, bulkier objects, and they all get stored right down here with ease. The other thing I want to point out that's something we're really proud of in our design is the undermount cockpit storage drawer. So when your portable cockpit table is not in use, it easily stows underneath the driver helm station and out of the way. So you just slide it in, slide it out, and then you have access to everything else that's still here in the storage area. Again, want to tie up, want to have lunch on the boat, want to have a cocktail at sunset, pull out your portable cockpit table, snap it into place, and enjoy yourself. One of the other design features of the E25 I'd like to point out is the oversized head compartment. Now again, as we progressed up the learning curve with our design, We've made this head compartment larger than the predecessor's E4 head compartment. I'm 6'1", 205 pounds, and I wanted to show you that I can step down into the head compartment and actually use it for what it's designed for. And then a lot of our competitors have much smaller spaces here, and they turn out to be nothing but storage areas for maybe bow filler cushions. That's not the case in a Crownline. The other thing is you have a removable faucet. So again, if you're enjoying yourself in the water all day, want to go have dinner by boat, maybe you want to change your clothes, you can shower off with the portable faucet. We have a built-in drain hole on the floor. You can change your clothes and you can go maybe enjoy dinner by boat. The other feature I'd like to point out is that in 2018, on the E5 and up, we went to granite countertops on all of our head compartments to really pull up the elegance of this area. The other nice feature on this particular boat, we have what's called a head door liner and head door in storage insert. What we have is a built-in shelf for items like shampoo. And then we also have a netting here. If you have maybe cosmetics or other items you don't want to fly around in the boat, they're held in place here in that storage netting. So this is another way to maximize the space inside the head compartment without feeling claustrophobic and making sure that everything is within reach. Let's talk about a few of the other exciting design and standard features on this new E25. First is the built-in fender storage. One of our most popular design features on both our bowriders and now standard on all of our new E-series, E25 and E27, it allows access to the storage area where you can drop in your oversized fenders and then close the lid, and then when you need access to them to pull them back out if you're going to tie up at the dock or with other boats. Another thing I want to point out is some of the design features that are tooled into the deck itself. This subtle ridge, or radius as we call it, is designed to improve the fit with your canvas on your deck. That way it helps reduce any type of water coming into your forward portion of the bow by having a much tighter fit with your cockpit canvas. We call that water damming in the industry. The other thing I want to point out is the stainless steel windshield lock, which is standard on all of our boats, 215 and up. It allows you to lock the windshield in place when the center door is open. That way it really ensures that it never slams shut, either catches somebody's fingers in the cutout area or hits somebody in the head. The other thing I'd like to point out is what we call the flush mount bow closeout doors. These are really high quality acrylic doors. They fold out and lock this area in place, and they can seal off the area between the bow and the cockpit. This is really important in areas for boating where the temperatures can change drastically from morning to night. Areas like Wisconsin, Minnesota, New England, Canada. A lot of these people really love the fact that they have the ability to close off the cold air coming into the cockpit by having these standard features, these bow closeout doors as standard features. And again, when they're not in use, they fully recess out of the way and the hinge locks them down in place. The other thing I want to talk about is there's a storage area here that comes standard with a trash can. You have a great place to store your garbage, a quick access to dump it in there. Also, by design, from the service side, it gives you access to the underside of your helm station. If you ever had to do any service work down the road, we design our boats so that you can always service the key components of your product. All right, let's take a few minutes to talk about the design features of the E25 bow. First, like all of our E-series boats, you have the option to either enter or exit the boat from one of the two four-step boarding ladders, either at the transom or also at the bow. And this is really a unique design to the E-Series because it allows you to enter and exit the boat in much shallower water, especially if you beach the boat or want to spend more time on land. The ladder opens up as it drops down for a four-step extension, easily retracts up. Also comes standard with the non-slip mat. The standard mat comes in a soft gray moonrock. I also want to talk about our new upholstery design for our new E-Series product. Not only just the look and feel of the upholstery, but also the design itself. We've gone to a diamond pattern on the lean backs, both in the forward portion of the bows, also in the rear sun deck, and we also redesigned the complete headrest. I'd like to call these the pillow top design. It's kind of a half circle overstuffed pillow top design, and it really allows you to recline back and enjoy the comfort of this bow. Now, one thing we have not abandoned is our hot tub style seating, but we have softened the design a little bit. It's still very much designed to embrace and support your legs from the right below the buttocks all the way through the midsection of your thigh. Now remember, this boat, we're shooting it for this video at a perfect level on a trailer. But when you're in the water, the boat attitude actually changes a little bit, has a little bit more bow rise and a little bit more transom down. All that does is really help to even embrace the 16-degree recline angle and the pillow top headrest to maximize comfort. Now, thinking ahead, we try to maximize every square inch of the boat for storage. So what we've done is we've designed these forward lean backs so that the whole one piece design articulates up and gives access to huge oversized storage. Now, this also maintains its position on its own so that you have a hands-free access to the storage area so you can load items in and out of the boat. The rear port side also lifts up and gives access to storage, but because of the head compartment and the rear bulkhead, the storage is a little bit smaller than on this side, but still a great little extra area for storage in the bow of the boat. We've also gone one step further, and we've designed in some floor storage. There's a small lid in the forward portion of the bow, easily raises up, and you can put additional items into the floor storage of the bow. So we've tried to maximize comfort, we've tried to maximize design, we've tried to maximize the ability to enter and exit the boat very safely and easily, and we've also tried to maximize storage, all in the bow design of this exciting new E25. So again, we look forward for the chance to earn your business at the upcoming boat shows, and please don't hesitate to contact Crownline if you have any questions about these exciting new boats.